I think that this POW WOW Nepal has been really starkly different. It's less like every man for themselves. It's more like we're a team together doing a thing for people who need something. And so that changes the whole vibe of what we're doing, and it's like we're here to give something back, and then there's no room for anyone's ego. This has been one of the most formative things I've ever done. I'm so grateful to be a part of this.
This is the first POW WOW Nepal. We're basically painting every surface within the school, all the classrooms, the exterior of the school. As a muralist, a lot of the time when you're painting these huge walls all over the city, it almost feels like it's for yourself or it's just for the art community. When you come to a school where nobody knows your name, it's a way more satisfying, more humbling experience because you're doing it for children.
It's been a really special experience because it's kind of like my two worlds coming together, right? So I've been in the US painting murals, painting for POW WOW, and I'm from Nepal, and for POW WOW Nepal to happen, it's super special for me.
I've never been to Nepal, and I didn't know what to expect, honestly. It's beyond just painting, you know, it's bringing something to people who will never see this stuff. So particularly, my room is the ocean in a landlocked country. None of these kids have seen the ocean. So half of them didn't even know what they were looking at. And the other half were super stoked on it and pretending to swim around the room in circles. And so I thought, as the kids look around, they get the feeling of being submerged in the ocean, just as a kind of way to give the ocean as a gift to these kids.
We all sat in a circle and looked at all the options and went for what spoke to us initially. And I wanted to paint a whole room to create an environment, because a lot of the kids here have been affected by the earthquake. It's been 3 years now. I just really like felt that I wanted to create an imaginative space for kids to escape to and feel like safe and magical and like optimistic about the future. So I sort of took like the things I had seen walking around Kathmandu and put my like fantastical spin on them.
I love this little area. This is, you know, this, the food, you know, comes out of here. That's a place to make, to adorn, to make precious, for sure.
My name is Shrine, and I make art out of trash. I just love that game, you know, taking things that have been discarded or that are ugly and taking them out of context and making them beautiful. In the reality that we're all sharing, the natural world exists. It doesn't create meaning. Human beings create meaning. So get busy and create the world you want to live in.
When I came to the school and saw the state of how the school was, I was like, oh my god. I got really excited to give something back to the kids. And when I got this space, I just sat here for a long time, imagining how it would be for a kid sitting in this classroom so many hours a day. I want this to like be the space, like once you close the door, that you're just in this imaginary world. You know, you have this girl who's like just dreaming. And what I painted here is like a flower, and above it is like this little squiggle, which for me represents hope and imagination. And hope doesn't have a specific shape. You have to use your imagination to bring hope.
Koseli School is a space for kids who come from the slums. Some of them are already living on the streets. I feel like it's a haven for them to just be around other kids, to receive some kind of education, to receive two meals a day, A lot of the times they don't receive food otherwise, and it's just a space for them to gather and be safe and be cared for.
Rachna is one of the nicest kids in the school, I would say. Well-disciplined, well-behaved, well-spoken. She's an amazing dancer. She doesn't mind participating in anything that is going on in school, you know?
My name is Rachna Dangalo. I'm in the Koseli School. I'm in the Koseli School. I'm in the Koseli School.
A few months back, Rachna came and she quietly handed a letter in my hands. She said, "Ma'am, you've helped us a lot, our education, our well-being, but it's still very tough for us. Our house is very far and we need about 120 rupees every day to come to school and go back home. So will it be possible for you to help me?" When you see that the child has potential, we would want to help her in any way possible.
Malai pachi gaera teacher banna man cha. Malai teacher banera aafu jastai garib bachha lai sitema padhauna man cha.
Koseli means a gift in Nepali, and that is what we all are getting being in Koseli.
Emotionally overwhelming for me to just see the kids be so excited and inspired and happy, and also just to watch my peers connecting with these kids, because I had this same experience last year and it was such a special experience for me that I want to share it.
I've never really considered working with children, and now I feel like a 180 degree change. And like, I've painted at schools before, and I feel like now, when I go home, I'm gonna need to do something more than just what I've been doing.
अनि पाव वाव नेपाल आउँदाखेरि हामीलाई एकदम धेरै रमाइलो पनि भएको थियो. स्कुलमा हामीलाई नयाँ नयाँ कुरा सिकाउनु भएको थियो. हामीले नयाँ कुरा पनि जान्ने मौका पायौँ. मलाई पछि पाव वाव नेपाल आएर पनि धेरै हेल्प गर्दै हुन्छ जस्तो लाग्छ. अब हाम्रो स्कुलको पनि सो फेरिन्छ.
It's always like amazing when you see kids that have an unfortunate background still be so happy and so innocent. It reminds me that what I do can mean something, and how little things can actually help the world make it a little bit brighter, even though it's just paint. And I don't know, this gives me hope.
Nepal has so much to offer in terms of the culture and its people, that when artists come here, you can't not feel something. And then for POW WOW Nepal here, we're working at the school, so building those relationships with kids and making art solely for them. So I think it's quite unique for artists to visit here and become part of POW WOW, which is one of the largest mural festivals in the world. So I think it's part of being something big and being part of something small at the same time, which is super amazing.
We're doing something that is not like anything I've ever seen POW WOW do before. And I think it's a good model, and it could be implemented everywhere. And I think it should be.
We're gonna remember you guys all until these paintings are here and beyond.